Hi, let's talk about the facial nerve. In this video, we'll discuss the facial nerve, cranial nerve 7, its distribution, and its branches distal to the stylomastoid foramen. So the facial nerve first enters the temporal bone through the internal acoustic meatus, which we can see there, sort of on that lateral surface of the petrous portion of the temporal. 7 is entering with 8. So facial and vestibular cochlear are going in through that opening. The facial nerve then takes a turn and enters into an osseous canal called the facial canal. The facial canal is Z-shaped and it is the largest osseous canal for a nerve. Within the canal, there are going to be 3 branches. 2 of them are going to be parasympathetic branches. They will conduct preganglionic parasympathetic fibers. The other will be a motor branch. And then the remainder of the nerve will continue on to exit through the stylomastoid foramen as the motor trunk. So here we can see a lateral view of the skull. This is the styloid process of the temporal. This is the mastoid process of the temporal. This is the styloid process of the temporal. And nestled between the two, right there, is the stylomastoid foramen. We could also see the external acoustic meatus there. And so coming through that stylomastoid foramen is going to be the motor trunk for facial. Within the canal, there are going to be 3 branches that are going to be important. These are going to be outside of the scope of this particular session, but they are going to come strongly into play in subsequent sessions. So facial nerve in the canal, the greater petrosal nerve. That greater petrosal nerve is going to conduct preganglionic parasympathetic fibers to the pterygopalatine ganglion. So from that pterygopalatine ganglion, postganglionic fibers are going to hitchhike along V2 to parasympathetically serve the lacrimal gland to produce tears for the eye. Also within that canal is going to originate the chorda tympani. The chorda tympani is going to travel through the middle ear. It's going to exit the skull and be in a place called the infratemporal fossa, where it's going to hitchhike along with branches of a V3 nerve called the lingual nerve. And just off of the lingual nerve is the submandibular ganglion. That submandibular ganglion serves the sublingual salivary gland and the submandibular salivary gland, and so those preganglionic parasympathetic fibers of chorda tympani are serving those salivary glands. Then we have the nerve to the stapedius muscle. So the stapedius muscle is a middle ear muscle that inserts on the stapes that helps to dampen any vibrations of the stapes so as to protect from loud sounds. And then the remainder of the motor root comes out the stylomastoid foramen, and it is going to serve the occipital belly of occipital frontalis and the muscles around the ear, or the auricular muscles, in particular the posterior auricular muscles, sometimes a little bit of the superior auricular muscle. This motor root is also going to serve one half of the digastricus muscle, so the posterior belly of digastric gets served, as well as the stylohyoid muscle. And then the remainder of that motor root is going out to serve the muscles of facial expression, or the mimetic muscles. And so this is how the nerve gets its name, because it is serving facial muscles. So Here's that lateral view again of the skull. There is the external acoustic meatus, the styloid process, I've got it right this time, the mastoid process, and there in between is that stylomastoid foramen. So here we see a lateral view of the head with the parotid gland and much of the parotid masseteric fascia stripped away as also part of the superficial musculoapponeurotic system stripped away so that we can see the divisions of the facial nerve. So there's the temporofacial division, there is the cervical facial division. These divisions are going to innervate the facial muscles. So they'll each have sets of branches, and these branches are named regionally by where they're heading to. So our temporofacial, temporal and facial division has temporal branches to serve the temple. Zygomatic branches, which is going over the zygomatic bone up towards the eye. Buccal branches, buccal cheek. And then there is the cervicofacial division. Cervicofacial also has buccal branches serving the cheek. A marginal mandibular branch serving that inferior margin of the mandible. And then a cervical branch, maybe that's right there, that is going down to innervate the platysma. Now, these branches are very conceptual and hypervariable, and so you shouldn't expect every donor to have the same branching pattern or even to have these large divisions. There's quite a bit of variation amongst people. But for the most part, look to where these branches are heading and name the branches by what region they're going to. So let's take a look at the lateral face again, this time with the parotid gland intact. So it is in situ. We also have the platysma muscle in situ. And we can see these nerves exiting from the substance of the parotid gland and heading off to innervate various things, which is very cool. So one of the nubs that we can see here is the posterior auricular nerve. That posterior auricular nerve is coming around the posterior auricle to the posterior of the auricle. The auricle is this portion of the ear. And it's going to innervate the occipital belly of occipital frontalis, as well as the posterior auricular muscle. And sometimes it might even give a branch to the superior auricular muscle, but that muscle is typically served by the
temporal branches of facial.
There's also the nerve to the digastric. That nerve to the digastric is serving the posterior belly of the digastric muscle, as well as stylohyoid muscle. Then we have all of the facial branches. And the facial branches are easily remembered by the very anatomically geeky mnemonic, 10 zebras bit my coccyx. The coccyx is the tailbone, I guess I should say, because this is a head and neck anatomy course. That's something that you would get in a full-bodied anatomy course. But 10 zebras bit my coccyx. So 10, temporal, zebras, zygomatic, bit, buccal, my, marginal mandibular, coccyx, cervical branch. So we can see some temporal branches, some zygomatic branches, some buccal branches, a marginal mandibular branch, and then we can see the cervical branch diving deep to the platysma there. And again, these branches are very conceptual and highly variable. And so, you know, no two patterns are going to be precisely alike. Now, in identifying these various branches, I think that it's helpful to look for certain landmarks. And so superiorly here, one landmark that I look for is the lateral canthus of the eye. And I kind of draw a line from that lateral canthus, back to the stylomastoid foramen. And anything superior to that line, I call a temporal branch. Anything inferior to that line, but not down around the cheek region, is a zygomatic branch. Here we can see a collection of muscles that are going to affect the oral fissure or the mouth. And so any of the fibers heading towards these muscles here are going to be buccal branches. So anything in the cheek region heading towards the mouth is a buccal branch. Along the most inferior margin of the mandible, like right along the base there, is the marginal mandibular. So they named that well. And then the cervical branch, cervical neck, is the one that actually descends into the neck. So that goes inferior to the mandible. And that leads us to our assessment question, that being the facial canal of the temporal bone begins at the internal acoustic meatus and ends at which distal opening? The external acoustic meatus? No, that's your ear hole. That's the space through which sound is traveling to the tympanic membrane. Foramen magnum? Well, that would be a circuitous route. No, that's brainstem, vertebral arteries, etc. Foramen rotundum? No, that's V3. Petrotympanic fissure? No, that's actually the space through which chorda tympani enters the infratemporal fossa. And so that leaves the stylomastoid foramen. Yep, nestled between the styloid and mastoid processes of the temporal bone is where that motor root is emerging from the facial canal out into the face. So thank you very much for your time.